Hi, everybody, and welcome back. Today, we are talking about forest bathing. It is a trend that has come out of Japan, and we're gonna break it down, talk about what it is, and we're gonna do it over this bottle of wine, or really just one glass. This bottle of wine is called Angels Landing Napa. Angels Landing, I'm pretty sure, is like a place in California that I've been to. I just don't remember where. Oh, I'm also gonna be talking to you about the notes that I taste in this. If you're familiar with any of these videos, I don't know wine well at all, other than I drink it a lot and I like know what I like and what I don't like. Anyway, the notes part, like, you're not gonna learn a lot from that. So that's the point. What else am I supposed to say? Oh, that's right. I am Tracy. I work over here at Eterneva. If you like videos like this, people who talk about grief, trying to remove the stigma around talking about grief and do it while they're drinking wine and talking to you about the notes, then go ahead and click that subscribe button so that you get notified every time we release one of these videos. So far, what do I taste? You're supposed to like swirl it, right? And smell? But has like a strong alcohol smell. Is it? No, it's a normal percent, 14.5. I don't know what's in it. I don't even know where to begin to like think about what's in it. I know I say grapes a lot, but I think that's like the only thing I know that's right. Maybe vanilla? Maybe. I don't know what's in it. Back to the topic. We are talking about forest bathing today. Now, if you have never heard of the term forest bathing, or even if you have and just kind of like ignored it, because what is that? You are not alone. I first heard about forest bathing probably like mid-2019, so not too terribly long ago, and then was super lucky to get the opportunity to participate in a forest bathing activity, except it was in a hotel and like a conference room in a hotel, but they did have plants there, so that was good. When you first hear about it, at least for me, the first thing I thought of was like some like hippie woman in the 70s with like a flower crown on, walking around probably naked in the forest. But that's not what forest bathing is, though. I mean, that might be like if you have, you know, like a secluded yard, or honestly, like, I mean, like just a yard in general. I mean, it's your property, I suppose. You could do that if you wanted to. So forest bathing is a trend coming out of Japan. There's a lot of health and wellness trends coming out of Japan right now. This one in particular seems to be really helpful for folks who are grieving. Let me give you a few quick hints and tips here. Forest bathing, you don't need to like take a class on it. You can just, you know, do it on your own. Few tips, go outside, take your shoes off, walk around in the grass. Even better if you can be surrounded by trees while you are doing it. Really what the whole goal of forest bathing is to help calm your mind, to get all of that chatter that makes you not be able to sleep at night or that causes you a bunch of anxiety, to calm down, to get a little bit quieter. And the reason why I guess it's taken form in forest bathing is because there are a lot of studies that show that the more around nature and greenery humans are, the calmer we get. It's almost like we evolved around nature. So it is very, very helpful to be out and around nature, especially if you are grieving. Also, this is pretty freaking easy. Like, you don't actually have to go to a forest. I mean, if you can like travel a little bit and maybe go to like a national park, that'd be really cool. Go do it near some redwoods, probably close to where Angel's Landing is. But you can also just go in your front yard, take your shoes off, walk around in the grass. Heck, maybe even do some gardening and call that forest bathing if you want. I mean, it's a trend coming out of Japan, but you can Americanize it. God, so what would really help me in these, determine what like might be in this, is to know what the possibilities are. Like, what could be in wine? There's a berry in here. Oh my gosh, I'm getting tips. Okay, the berry, it's a raspberry. Is it really? No, it's not. Okay. Is there caramel in here? No, it's not. Okay. So I will say something that I did a lot growing up was I would go outside and lay under, we had these big pecan trees in Beaumont, Texas, in my yard. I'd go out there, lay under those, and like literally just lay in the grass. The grass in Beaumont is like so nice. It's like that big, thick grass. I don't know what it's called, but it's like a carpet. You can just lay on it. And I would just be out there for hours, just like watching the clouds. And that, I guess, was a good form. I did that a lot in high school. So maybe that was like drama and stuff. I will say there have been times that nature has attacked me, but it was probably my fault. One time while sitting under a tree, I got attacked by a lot of fire ants. Fun fact about fire ants, they didn't used to be in the United States, and they were brought over by ships from the Caribbean. Great. And they just spread out all over. They are terrors. So the average American spends 93% of their time indoors. That is absolutely insane. Not to mention, I suppose, that so many people live in metropolitan areas and probably only get outside when they are traveling to and from work. But you do not actually have to go outside in order to participate in something called forest bathing. So part of what makes forest bathing is the way that you activate the senses. So if you want to participate in forest bathing, but it's like -2 degrees outside, and so you like don't want to go, or you don't have a lot of time, or maybe you don't have, maybe like the closest park is, 5 miles from you and you don't have a car, rollerblades, then you can instead literally walk outside down your street. Maybe there's a park nearby. It doesn't have to be far. Maybe it's to the end of the block, but just get outside and put one foot in front of the other. Something as simple as that can really, really help. Again, what this is doing is it's just helping to ground you, giving you also small steps, right? Oh, it could be really paralyzing about grief is how overwhelming it is and how many expectations we feel like people have on us, from, you know, planning funerals or celebration of life to getting back to work or taking care of kids, or heck, if you have a friend or family member who's grieving, you know, trying to figure out what you can do for them, it just feels overwhelming. So start small, take really small chunks out of it. Honestly, just taking some chunks out of social media and getting outside and walking can be really, really helpful. So again, forest bathing, ultimately a trend that is happening in Japan. You see it even at some national parks here in the United States as well. Again, you do not have to participate in those activities. Those activities are really cool and great though, because they add some structure to it all. So that was it. That's all you have to do. So whether you go and participate in some kind of formal forest bathing, or if you just want to go to like a national park and walk around, you can even take your shoes off there. There's like no rules against that. Whatever you do, make sure it feels right for you. Also, don't worry if it feels weird or kooky at first. That is totally fine. All you were trying to do is find a little bit of an outlet for your brain to rest. So leave the phones, leave the text messaging, leave the YouTubes even behind, and just get out there, even just for a little bit. It can be 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 30 minutes. If you are real cool, maybe you'll do an hour. Whatever it is that you feel like ultimately will help. What does this pair well with? Well, I mean, so I'm a vegetarian, so if it's with meat, which I imagine it is, then I'm out of luck. I don't know, probably a red meat. Isn't red wine good with like red meats? Is that a thing? Strong, boldly flavored foods, which maybe then for vegetarians, it would go well with like a portobello mushroom grilled on a sandwich. I don't know, is bread good with wine? Probably. It does smell really good, it really does. I like this wine. I think out of the wines I've had so far, I like this one the best. I almost like got up my nose. I was trying to be a professional sommelier. I've gotten better at that word. I wouldn't recommend that though. Now I get to actually tell everybody what's in this. Dark and rich aromas. Chocolate, man, see, I did know chocolate. Cherries, okay. Boysenberry. They told me there was a berry in this as a hint, like I would ever guess boysenberry. Has anyone like seen a boysenberry? Do you guys know what boysenberries look like? Plums. And mint. Okay, flavors of black cherry, plum, dark chocolate, and mint linger on the palate. Do they? I don't even like mint. And I liked this. If I liked, Cool. That's all we got on forest bathing and getting outside and going on really cool hikes or gardening or just Americanizing forest bathing in general. Remember, everything that you do during this time in your life is really up to you. Truly, you get to do whatever you want. I am just here to offer a few ideas and hopefully make you like smile at least like once. That would be good for me to know that I did. Anyways, if you like these kinds of videos or if you like following along, then please go ahead and subscribe and watch some of our other stuff as well. We release these, you know, either once a week or once a month. I've had too much wine. We'll be doing more. Today we are talking about how pets can help with grief, and we are doing it with this lovely bottle of mineralii.